geologists rely on information from deep beneath the Earth's surface to reconstruct the past. As sediments accumulate over time, they create records geologists use to understand Earth history and to predict future processes and trends. The most common way to get this information is to drill a hole in the Earth where sediments have been deposited over time. The sediments drilled are recovered in the form of a core that will contain an intact record of the past. Core samples are used to assess the geologic history of an area, such as its geomorphology, coastal, marine, and terrestrial processes, and changes in environmental quality. The type of drilling tool used for cores depends on how deep and how hard the sediments are. Vibracoring is one of the tools used in shallow coastal areas where sediments consist of soft sand and mud. Hi, and welcome to the U.S. Geological Survey Coastal Marine Geology Podcast. I'm Matthew Simatile. I'm here with two marine geologists, Kyle Kelso and Nancy DeWitt. They are part of the St. Petersburg Coastal Marine Science Center's Seafloor Mapping Group. They have taken cores in coastal areas all around the U.S. Together, this team of scientists analyzes geologic information to reconstruct Earth history and to predict future trends. We'll be talking to them about what it takes to collect a sediment core using a vibracoring rig from a boat platform. Nancy, can you tell me what we're seeing here?
That's the RVGK Gilbert that we use for seafloor mapping purposes. What you're going to see today is taking sediment fiber cores off of the boat.
It has a nice big deck to hold the tripod and also to handle all the equipment that is necessary to perform our field work.
We have a captain up in the top on the flybridge, and we are positioning over the place that we're going to take a sediment core. And in order to do that, you have to have a stationary boat. So we have a two-point anchor in this situation. Sometimes in rougher seas, you need a three-point anchoring situation.
We're hooking up the pipe to the vibracore head. It connects just by a little clamp there, and then we raise it up. And getting ready to insert the entire rig into the water.
Rich is raising it up with the crane, and then we lock the barrel in place so it stays vertical.
The rig will sit on the seafloor bottom, and it'll vibrate and penetrate the sediment until the head reaches the bottom.
In this situation, this rig is set up for 20-foot barrels. Sometimes we can take it down to 10 feet. On a manual vibracoring setup, you can use 40-foot barrels to have a continuous record. The goal is to get a continuous record as long as possible. Normally, this rig's underwater, but since we're only in about 6-7 feet, you get to actually see the electronic vibracore head, the black part right there, actually shake the barrel. It liquefies the sediment around the barrel, which allows the barrel to enter the seafloor.
It's pretty shallow water here, but we are able to collect water depths in excess of 200 feet. We're guiding it out back onto the deck of the boat. You can see the weight of the coring rig pulling the boat to the side, and sometimes when the core gets stuck in the sediment, the angle of the deck is is about 30 degrees in some instances. Got to make sure you wear closed-toed shoes.
That's a 2-ton crane that Rich is operating there. Allows us to handle the weight.
And the sediment in those barrels do weigh a lot, I'll tell you that. Tripod's in place, rinsing it down.
You end up marking the outside of the barrel. It's very important which end is up because we're taking a section of geologic history and we are trying to piece history back together. So it's chronologically important to know which end is up.
Right now, Shanda was tapping to see where the sediment surface was, and she is releasing the water above the sediment surface in order to be able to cut the core without any danger. Because those cores get really heavy, especially when they're saturated like that.
She's using a pipe cutter. Plumbers use those things a lot. It's just a cleaner cut, straight cut. It's faster than hacksaw.
So here we are cutting again right at the sediment surface. That initial cut was just an estimation because we didn't really know where the sediment surface was. Getting rid of as much void in the core as possible. And you'll see us stuffing, in this case, paper towels in order to keep the sediment from moving around while it's in the core.
That is a very, very, very heavy sediment core right there. You'd be surprised. It looks like a toothpick, but it's very heavy. It takes two people to move it.
That was Chandra marking the top, the naming of the core, and marking the top and bottom.
Thanks, Kyle and Nancy, for your time and for explaining the process of vibracoring. Now, once the core is brought back to the lab, it will be cut into meter sections and split lengthwise into two halves. One core will be kept for archiving and one core will be kept for sampling. The archiving core would be photographed and stored in plastic bags for future reference. The sediment core could be analyzed for grain size analysis and age through radiometric dating. Learn more about USGS science online at usgs.gov. The Coastal Marine Geology Podcast is produced in St. Petersburg, Florida, and is a product of the U.S. Geological Survey, Department of the Interior.